So hello guys, I am back with a new chapter of class 9th NCERT Bihar chapter 2, The Sound of Music. So the author of the story is Marlia Von Trapp, Russell Crowe and Horace Lindsay. So the story is mainly divided into the two parts. The first part is about a girl named Evelyn, and the second part is about the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. So first we will read about the part 1. This part of the story is about a Scottish girl named Evelyn. She was very fond of music. She lost her hearing power at a very young age. It was first noticed when she was 8 and confirmed at the age of 11 years. She was completely deaf due to the nerve damage. Evelyn Glennie didn't give hope and never looked back. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. She loved music. Once she saw a girl playing xylophone and decided to play it. Most of the teachers discouraged her, but her precisionist Ron Forbes encouraged her, and Ron Forbes helped him to continue with the music. He made her learn music by making her feel different notes in her body. The rest was a sheer determination and hard work. She had decided to make music her life. She audienced for Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of Academy. She gradually left orchestral work and started giving solo performances. At the end of the 3 years course, she had received most of the top awards. She explained that music flows through every part of her body. It tingles in the skin, her cheekbones, and even in her hair. When she plays the xylophone, she can sense sound passing up a stick into her fingerprints. By learning against drums, she can feel the resonances, means sound, flowing into her body. On a wooden platform, she removes her shoes so that the vibration could enter the feet and up her legs. She is a perfect example that anyone could achieve his goal. And now we come to the second part, that is the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. A musical instrument called Pungi was banned by the Emperor Aurangzeb for its shrill, unpleasant sound. There was a musical instrument called Pungi, which was banned by the Aurangzeb because it has a very shrill voice and it recognized a name for the reeded noise makers. It was perfected by a barber who belonged to a family of a professional musicians. He played it in the chamber of the kings. Its sound was appreciated by the emperor. Since it was born in the Shah's chamber and perfected by Nai, it was named Shehnai. In the beginning, it was played in the temples on marriages and occasions and became the popular. Ustad Bismillah Khan belonged to the Benaras Gharana. He was born in the 1916 at Damrohan in Bihar. As a 5-year-old boy, he would play a gilli danda near a pond. He used to visit a Biharaji temple. He would earn a big laddu from a local Maharaja as a prize, and he was very happy. At the age of 6, he moved to Benares. His uncle Ali Bucks introduced him to the necessities of playing in Shehnai. He was deeply devoted to music. He used to spend most of his time practicing on the banks of River Ganga. The themes of his music are deeply affected by the flowing water of Ganga. The Ganga was a river, and he is very influenced by its river. The themes of his music are deeply affected by the Ganga. He got the Best Performer Award in the All India Music Conference in Allahabad in 1930. In 1937, he bagged 3 medals at a music conference in Calcutta. He was invited by the Pandit Nehru from the Ramparts on the Red Fort in 1947. and he became the first Indian to greet the nation with his shehnai. And his audience were Pandit Nehru and Mahatma Gandhi. 1947 was a very auspicious day as India got independence. He won many international awards as well. He ventured in the film too. He gave his music in the two movies, but the artificial cinema could not attract him. For him, music is a god, music is his soul, and he loved India. He also got an invitation to start a Shehnai school in the USA, but he could not live outside India, so he opposed the proposal. His son, his student also wanted that he goes to the USA and start a school, but he did not agree. So with that, our story ends. And if you like my video, please like and share it. For more lessons, subscribe my channel. And stay home, stay safe, keep learning. Thank you.